Julian Dunn has posted a request on our Facebook page for a method of painting Ironbreaker's armour. Now, to paint these heavily armoured Duardin, what you should do is undercoat your miniature with Lead Belcher spray, and then the colours you'll need are Retributor armour, first of all, for all the trim, and then Norn oil to shade the entire miniature. After that, we use Ironbreaker, of course, to layer the armour and make it nice and shiny again, and as for the trim, we're going to use Liberator Gold for that. Finally, we'll add a very fine highlight of Stormhost Silver. But we're going to be starting out with Retributor armour applied with a medium layer brush, and what you want to do is use your palette here to get the paint under control, because you're going to be applying essentially fine lines here. So be sure to thin your paint down as always, and then just use that palette to get rid of the excess paint so you've got a good tip on your brush. So on my miniature, you can see I've already undercoated with Lead Belcher, and what I'm going to do is just neatly as possible start picking out all this trim. Next, shade all over your miniature using Norn oil, and keep an eye on this as it dries to make sure it doesn't pull too much towards the feet of the miniature. Once the Norn oil is completely dry, you're ready to apply a layer of Ironbreaker to all the silver parts of the armour, and you want to paint most of this just going close to the edge where you meet that gold, just leaving the dark line still showing between the two colours. The next step is to highlight all the trim using Liberator Gold, and you just want to be as neat as you can as you follow it all the way round. And finally, use Stormhost Silver to highlight all the edges of the silver detail. And here we have the completed armour, and you can see by painting this method we've got a wonderful shine to it as well. So Julian, I really hope that helps you out, and that the rest of you enjoyed that video too, and we'll see you all again very soon.